H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Format. So what's the advantages of ORM? Let's business code access objects than TB tables. Hide the details of SQL queries from object-oriented logic. We don't want SQL queries now. Based on JDBC under the hood. Under the hood, everything is JDBC. Okay. It's just doing it by XML way. No need to deal with the database implementation. Okay. You don't have to worry what database it is. SQL queries are dependent on the database. You know that. Okay. But here, even the query generation is completely outsourced to the Hibernate. Entities based on the business concepts than a database structure. Entities means beans. Okay. Again, new word. So this also bean is also called as entity. Okay. Some people in some books, okay, especially Hanuman Deshmukh's book, you can see that's a very famous book. Okay. It's Advanced Java EE Concepts, the book name. It's written by Hanuman Deshmukh. It's world famous. It's a really famous book. Okay. The concept is, POJO concept is called as entity beans. Okay. So this combines both the words. Okay. Some people use POJO, okay? Especially Cathib, Sierra, Brett Burns. Those guys use POJO word. Okay. Bean word, normally if you go around with Google around and see blogs and all, they use bean. Just a bean. Okay. So there are confusing states, but ultimately we are talking about one constructor, one class name and getters and setters. Done. Okay. Entities based on business concepts. So entities are now based on business concepts, not the database structure. Okay. Transaction management and automatic key generation. This is the benefit. We're going to see that. How do we do that? Okay. And fast development of application. Now you don't have to worry about these all things. Automatically your business logic will be more focused. And that's what our application need. So we will develop our business logic faster than JDBC. Okay, we are not worried about how to map the database and how to convert that into string and integer and all kind of stuff. ORM solution consists of following four entities. One is it performs basic CRUD operation of the object of persistent class. Okay, persistent class is a class. Okay, again, this class in this particular class which we are talking about, POJO bean entity beans, is called as persistence class in Hibernate. Okay. But ultimately again we are talking about the same stuff. A language or API specify queries that refers to the classes and properties of the properties of classes. Okay, refers to classes and property of classes. A configurable facility for specifying mapping metadata. Configurable facility, that XML file which I just showed you. A technique to interact with the transactional object to perform dirty checking, lazy association. So I'll tell you what is this. Okay, transactional object, dirty checking, lazy association, fetching and all kind of stuff. Okay, so that we're gonna learn anyway. Okay, so these are the solutions all automatically provided. So this is how it will look like. Your Java objects interact with the ORM or Hibernate objects, and ORM objects are interacting with the RDBMS, and this is two-way arrow. Okay, this arrow is not visible properly, but you can see this is two-way arrow. So even the reverse process happens in the same manner. Okay, up to now any problems? We will actually go inside Hibernate now and see what are the objects Hibernate has. Anything, any questions, why we are doing that, and all kind of, these words, dirty checking, lazy association, all kind of stuff you're gonna learn. Okay, don't worry about that. These are properties of Hibernate. Okay, let's continue. Some advantages, we already discussed this, like we map XML, okay, we don't use a line of code, okay. Provide simple API for storing and retrieving Java objects. There is change in database, then only XML file changes. Your query remains the same. Okay, you don't have to worry about the query at all. Abstract way, unfamiliar SQL. Okay, Hibernate does not require application server. Okay, manipulate complex association, minimize database access. Okay, provide simple querying of the data. Okay, it has internal cache also. That also we're gonna learn in our last sessions, what is caching mechanism, so you don't have to go to database again and again. Okay, now we'll go deep dive into Hibernate, how exactly Hibernate looks like. So this is Java application, this is your persistent object, that is your employee object, and your employee object is actually using Hibernate. Okay, Hibernate is using multiple objects. So before actually starting this, let me go ahead and actually tell you how to download Hibernate. So go to hibernate.org. It's a separate project altogether, it's a separate website, you can download the latest version of it, it's completely free. Hibernate.org. Okay, you can see there are a lot of things Hibernate do. Hibernate search, Hibernate validator, OGM and all other things. You have to work about Hibernate ORM. Okay, so more. Okay, and that's a download. This is it, and you download that. Click on download, it will download the latest version of Hibernate for you. Okay. Okay, it will ask where to save, and you can save it somewhere. It is 98 MB, I'm not gonna do it, pause. Okay, and you can download the latest version of it. Once you have that hibernate.zip file, you just open it, it will have a library folder. Would you please give an architecture diagram that you will learn in design patterns? Okay. In case of Hibernate versus JDBC, there is no difference in that. Okay. It has to be same. Business layers, Pojo. Pojo is not a layer. Pojo is just, this is like model objects. Okay. They're also called as data transfer objects. So this is the Pojo is required to transfer the data. Okay, I may not be there, I will upload that. So Pojos are required to transfer the data from one layer to another layer. Okay, and DAO layer is for data access, but we have this entire discussion in our design patterns, J2E design patterns. Hibernate material may not be there, I will upload that. Okay, so now we have this Hibernate total concepts. Okay, once you download that, you have a leaf folder, and that leaf folder you can just include in your project. So how do I do that? Actually, go to properties, Java build path. Okay, you can see Hibernate here, that has all the library files. How do I edit this? Okay, you can use add library. Okay, then you say user library. Okay, then if you don't have it, you can just click on user libraries. Okay, create new, name it that your Hibernate. Okay, my Hibernate or new Hibernate, whatever. Okay, add the jars, whatever new jars you added. Okay, you can actually have external jars. Okay, whatever jars you want to add, you can add it here and done. Similarly, I added it here, you can see. OPT temp Hibernate required. Okay, so add external jars. OPT temp Hibernate required. And these are the jars I'm adding and open. Okay, so this jars will be get added into it, and then you can use this. And just click on OK. It will be added in your project. Okay. But I don't want that. Cancel. I already have Hibernate here. Okay. So this is addition of user library. Okay. You can directly add the jar files. There is no harm in doing that. This is a good way of doing it. Okay, with the help of user libraries, you can do this stuff for MySQL and other stuff also. Okay, Hibernate is added, and now click on OK. So Hibernate is available on your project, in your project. Okay, now this is Done. Now, what are the objects which are responsible for different things in Hibernate? Just like we know that JDBC has a different layers, like you have JDBC API, you have driver manager, you have driver, and what you pass is SQL query. Okay. Here we have six layers, six things to configure, to six different concepts to learn. So first thing is configuration. So let's learn this concept. So Hibernate layers. So first is configuration. You need configuration for what? So configuration is your DB mapping. Where to connect? Okay. How to connect? What's the username, password? All kind of stuff is a configuration. So to configure a Hibernate, you need config.cfg, config.hbm. Okay, cfg.hbm, cfg.hbm. That is Hibernate. Okay, HBM file is a Hibernate file, Hibernate mapping file, I'll say. Okay, that's what it is, HBM. So there is a file in your project. There is a file in project called as Hibernate.cfg.xml. So this is what is a file. Okay, and here you will map your database. You will say that your Hibernate dialect is MySQL. What is dialect? I'll tell you. Okay, your driver, your connection URL. Okay, your username, your password. Okay, you can see everything is Hibernate.connection. Okay, Hibernate.connection username, Hibernate.connection URL. All these things are required for connection. Okay. Forget about this, we are going to learn this in the last class. Okay, even last one. So these are required things, if you remember, these are required things for JDBC connection, even for. So you can see driver class, URL, username and password. This is what was needed for JDBC connection. There is something called a dialect. We will see what exactly it is. So this file is called as configuration file, and the Hibernate Java classes, which are actually responsible for reading this and making connection, are also categorized as configuration classes. Okay, so configuration classes are required to set your Hibernate and make a connection. Configuration object, what are the things it has? Okay, what it does, database connection, this handles through the one or more configuration files supported by Hibernate. These files are Hibernate properties and Hibernate okay, either you can put in a property file or you can put cfg.xml. We generally use XML. Okay, and class mapping setup. So class mapping also we saw like this, employee hbm.xml. Okay, so this type of files are whatever XML files you need for Hibernate are actually configuration files. So this is the first object you need. Okay, you need class level mapping and you need database mapping. Okay. Second step, what exactly you need is session factory. What is session factory? A configuration object is used to create session factory object, object which in turn configures Hibernate for application using supplied configuration file. Whatever configuration file you gave, with that there will be one object which is created called a session factory. And as you know, the name itself says that session factory. So what it is providing? Okay, chocolate factory provides chocolate, so session factory provides session. That's simple. So session factory provides us sessions. Okay, and you don't need chocolate factory at every city. Okay, that can be one place and it will be providing sessions to everyone. So that's why session factory also, it's not required again and again. You curate it once, you keep it once, and then all the sessions will be created from the session factory. The session factory is thread-safe object and used by all the threads of an application. Session factory is a heavyweight object and so usually created during the application startup and kept for later use. Okay. Now third is session object. Now we learned about session factory. Session factory provides what? It actually reads the configuration, reads config, okay, and creates, it will say, it will provide sessions. That's the use of session factory. Okay, it provides sessions. So what is the use of session? Session is a real interaction, a physical connection from database to DB. From database to Java. Okay, so this is the real connection where all the interaction thing happens. So this is where you will use SQL queries will be executed on session object. Okay, so persistent object are saved and retrieved through the session object. Remember that. So saving, retrieving, all kind of queries will be executed on session. Session object should not be kept open for the long time. So session is something which is specific for the queries. You start it, you do the action, you close it. Okay, and done. So session is for a specific task. You complete the task and it's done. Then you have transaction object. Transaction is unit of work. Okay, let me explain a little bit about transaction. What is transaction? Let's say I need an additional, I need the next customer ID. Okay, I'm saving a customer ID. Okay, I need a next customer ID. What I will do? I got the customer details. Okay, now I go to the database. I ask for last updated customer ID. Okay, that is a query. Then I take that, add one to it. Okay, that is my new customer ID. And I save my customer with that new customer ID. Right? All this operation is a single unit of work. Okay, is a single unit of work. Okay, unit of work means a logical sequence of activities which has to be done in a single shot. Okay, that is a unit of work, logical set of activities. Now let's say if I am going to the database for saving my customer and I'm retrieving a customer ID throws an error. Okay, so my first step itself is thrown an error. That's why my second step should not be executed, right? So I can manage that kind of stuff. I can use this sequence in a single transaction. Okay, that is called a transaction. Remember, you can remember our banking transactions. When you're transferring an amount, let's say you want to transfer $5,000. The first thing bank checks is whether you have that balance of $5,000. That's the first step. Second step is another beneficiary where you are actually transferring the amount is added in your bank, whether it's a valid or not. So all kind of steps bank has to get executed. Okay, bank has to execute and then only it will initiate the transfer and transfer will be completed. If any of the steps in between do not execute properly, transaction fails. Okay, so that's why it's called as transaction. Okay, transaction is a unit of work. Now while interacting with the DB also, we categorize that unit of work and see